Paige, and today we're going to be making Rosanna Pantsina's little poop emoji brownies. And I have everything I need, chocolate melts, brownie mix, everything else, and we're not going to be fancy today, but we are going to be using a set because we don't have everything to make the brownies. So I got my little bowls. I got little bowls, big bowls, water, olive oil spray for the mold, olive oil, water, and eggs. So yes. So we're gonna be taking our bowl. We're gonna take this one, and it has the grip on the bottom that came from my set, so it doesn't move when you're stirring. So we gotta get a whisk. Where's the whisk? Where's mine? Oh, I see mine. So I got my whisk because ours are really heavy, and yeah. So I got my little whisk, and I think we're ready. Eggs, we gotta get eggs.
Which one?
This one? This one, Mom? This one? Okay, we got our eggs. So, first you wanna take your brownie mix and read the directions. And this one says, preheat your oven to 325. So we're gonna let this bake. And now it's preheating. And while that's preheating, we're gonna make our brownies, our brownie mixture. Not very sharp. Be careful. So this one is double chocolate, and it has chocolate chips inside. So if you see chunks, that's the chocolate chip. Okay. So then we're just gonna take a fourth cup of water. And I got my little bowl of water here. And we're just gonna take a little. And then we're gonna a third cup of vegetable oil. And if you're wondering, I make cakes and bake brownies all the time, so I kind of know what to do. It's like in my brain now, on ingredients to use and everything. But just to make sure, I read the bottle every single time. The box. Bottle? Box? Which one? Box, bottle? I don't know. Make sure you get no shells in your eggs. And no shells in your brownie mix. Should I throw that away or just put it back?
No, it's fine.
Okay. I'm gonna wash my hands now because when you use eggs, you always have to wash your hands after. Okay, I washed my hands and now you just wanna mix. So you want to beat up the egg. Okay. Okay. Oh, my arm's already tired. It's so thick. But you just want to get everything off the sides. I'm pooped. Okay. So the brownie mix is not done, but if you can see closely, there is chunks, like big chunks, like right there, and right there, and right there, and like everywhere. Those are chocolate chips, and they're just gonna melt in the oven, so. I think that's good. So the oven just beeped and we just realized there's only 6 poop molds and this is a lot of brownie mix. So we just got out this heart mold and they have little hearts inside and it's a really fun mold and yeah. So we're just gonna fill our batter up with the poop molds first. And then, if we have enough batter, which we probably will, we will fill up at least 3 of them if we have enough batter. So, I also got this mini for Petit Mom.
Yes.
So, we're just gonna fill up our poop molds first. So, this is what it looks like. So this is what it looks like. Just the inside, it's a silicone mold. It's really flexible. And we're just gonna, so when we put it in the oven, should we put this on a tray in the oven? Cause it's like, I think we should.
Okay. You don't have to use that one.
You don't have to use a tray, but since this is really flexible, I'm gonna use a tray because I don't trust myself when putting them in and putting them out, taking them out. So when you take them out, you make sure that you let them cool off, or you take like a little a little toothpick and pick every single one of them just to make sure it's done. So you just stick it in the middle and then you go to the next one, and if there's stuff on the toothpick, then they're not done. Are you zooming in my face? But if the toothpick is clean, then it is done. So, we're just gonna start filling up the poop molds first. Should I go this side or this side? I'm gonna go this side. So we're gonna clean this up after. So you just wanna get everything out of your whisk. Not working. I'm trying it. Oh, that's good. Okay. So, come here. This is how you know when the brownie mix is done, when it's really spreadable and it just like sticks there, and when it's really thick and hard to whisk, like whatever it's called. Hard to mix. I don't know Don't fling it at me. See, it's not coming out.
We'll use it to
scoop.
Yeah.
I usually use a spatula or That's good enough.
Or you know what? Maybe use
a spatula. Your spatula's in here. Just get my mini spatula.
That's awesome.
Look, it's over here.
Where?
They're really hidden. They're hidden because they're mini and all these are big.
Okay, use that to poke through it.
This is my miniature spatula for kids. We have a lot of baking stuff for kids because me and my dad are really the only people who cook. I helped make breakfast this morning.
What'd you make?
Eggs and bacon and tortillas.
So why do you like to bake?
Because it's just really fun. And the best part about baking is you get to lift the spoon in the bowl. Where do I put this?
Can we put it in your bowl?
No, that's water.
So, are you going to use it again?
No, I was going to lick that though.
Oh, so. Okay. Well,
we'll just set it by
we'll
the water.
Put it right there. How about that?
If it falls, that's your fault. So now we're just going to use our spatula, or like you could use the measuring tools to put it in here. You can really use anything, actually. I like to use spatulas and cook like really anything. We have piping bags.
Babe, put it in there.
Oh, like measuring things, like just scoop it and then put it in there.
Maybe a spoon would be good.
Probably better. Okay, so we're gonna use a spoon. And you wanna, for cake, you would usually do like halfway. Wow, that was not a lot. I didn't realize how small this was. We forgot to spray it.
I'll just do that one without spraying it. And then spray the others.
Okay, note to self, this is the bad one. Somebody else can have that one. That's all. So since this is like brownies, and they don't rise as much as cakes, you just wanna fill it up till about right about there. So it's almost there actually. But you just wanna put up a little more. Not really till it's full, because if it's full, then it will overlap and then it will get on this and then it's really hard to get off, so.
Have you ever used this mold before?
No, never. I haven't made brownies in a while. I usually make cakes more than brownies. So you just wanna, when they're all done, you'll just like slap it down and so it levels it. And we forgot to put our, our olive oil cooking spray. You can also use Pam, but this is way healthier than Pam. So yeah. Oh, I love this part, but I'm so bad at it. Okay, so this is an example why you don't put Pam in there, because when this is done, the one by the row, we'll know that this one is the bad one and it won't pop out as good as these will. So since this is a mold and it's silicone, it should pop out good, but I don't know for sure. And since they go deep down, where you have to like get closer up to it, so when you're using just a pan, you would just go shh and be done, and make sure you get the corners and stuff. That. But since this one goes down farther, we have to spray. That was a lot of spray. Oh, I'm bad at this. Go farther away. I'm not good at this. This is what you shouldn't do. All
right, turn it around because you only got one side.
I did.
Turn it around, yeah.
Especially this one.
Back up a little bit.
I'm spraying everything. This one didn't get anything.
Alright, that's good.
Yeah, these are really gonna pop out. Do I just use my finger to like spread it around?
No.
Is it good?
It's fine, obvious.
Ow! Ow.
So why'd you say ow?
Because I have cut my hand. So like I said, this is way more healthier. That spray is way more healthier than Pam, because Pam has, what does it have in it? I don't know. But it's like way healthier. Okay, this is just sliding around. That's not good. Maybe we should have put a little less.
That's good enough for that one.
That one's really spraying. That's what you shouldn't do. Just don't do it. Get an adult to do it. Probably you should have done that.
Well, I'm filming.
Oh, yeah.
At your request.
Stop dripping. While the brownies are cooking, baking, whatever they do, we'll be using Rosanna Pansino's candy melter. It's like a pot. It's a candy melting pot. That there. That's enough, right?
Yeah.
These are basically just like cupcakes. But you want to make sure you get it all the way down to the bottom, or not. If you don't, then it won't look good, because the top will be missing.
I wonder if the brownies are gonna work best or chocolate cake.
Probably chocolate cake. She used brownies.
Oh, she did.
She used brownie mix. Shout out to my mom for buying this and recording this.
Woohoo! I got a shout out.
Don't ruin it.
Huh?
Don't ruin it.
Don't ruin it.
Don't ruin it. I think this one's the best. Even though that's the bad one that didn't get sprayed. I don't know, that's a lot of brownie mix left. That sound. You hear it? It's like. This is as thick as molasses. I'm not joking, it's really thick. Molasses is probably thicker, but.
Alright, once we put this one in the oven, pause the video, okay?
Will we?
No, because you can do that.
Out. The
yeah.
Video.
And then we'll come back to the video when you are taking them out.
Okay. Are we gonna auto that out?
I don't think that I know how to do that. Just finish them.
There's actually not that left, actually. There's not that much left.
No.
I mean, it's probably enough for that, but those are bigger molds, so I don't know. Okay, we are all done, and we're gonna pause the camera and go on to that one. And by the time these are done baking, we'll show you the results. Okay guys, the timer went off and it's time to take them out. I'm getting over my fears of hot surfaces. I'm scared. Okay guys, now we have to let them cool, but now we are gonna go over here and get our chocolate looking. Okay.